What's up, guys? It's your Motivational Gamer here, and today we bring you another episode of our map series. In this particular series, we put each individual unit on the map. We talk about that particular monster, its abilities, and its purpose in combat to help you guys make a more educated decision as to whether or not to include, improve, or remove this current monster from your box. So due to special requests, we have the Dark Charger Shark Calicus that we're talking about today. So Calicus is an attack type monster, right? So he comes with three basic skills. His first skill, Lunging Wave, which is his basic attack, which increases his critical rate for one turn, which gives him a strong ability to deal some major damage as an attack type unit. His second skill, Incapacitate, deals damage to all enemies. And this attack has a 50% chance to decrease attack power and the attack speed for two turns. Now, if you're using this particular skill, typically, depending on what the circumstance is, you might want to lead with Incapacitate first or lead with Lunging Wave first, depending on how you have this particular unit built. Now, Incapacitate can be very helpful, especially if he's a fast unit, because his base speed is not really that low. You know, being at 105, he's able to reduce the enemy's attack speed and in turn give the rest of your team more turns, especially if you have this unit fast. Third skill, Chow Down, which performs an attack that deals more damage accordingly to how low the enemy's HP is. If the enemy has lower than 30% HP, the attack does 100% more damage, so that's double damage. Now, upon awakening, he increases the attack speed of all ally monsters that are dark by 23%, but this is not where he's going to shine. Now, if you have this particular unit or you're building this particular unit, you have to understand that all you're going to be doing with this unit is smacking the shit out of people, period. That's his primary purpose, is to crush motherfuckers. Motherfuckers run up, psh, get smacked down. That's what he does. So if you're building this particular unit, you're going to want him fast, okay? So a lot of speed, mainly through substats. You're going to want to follow the typical attack format that I recommended in the rune guide, which was, you know, attack percent, crit damage, attack percent, and you're going to want to make sure that his crit rate is at least 70%. Normally, I would say 100%, but his first skill, every time he attacks, increases his critical rate for one turn, but so that's going to give you a little bit of cushion. So make sure you max his speed, max his critical damage, and make sure that his crit rate is at least 70%. Once you get his crit rate to 70%, he's going to be a wrecking ball. So your job with the rest of your team is literally to make sure that they lower the HP of the enemies, and then you let Calicus go through. And if he's fast with high crit rate, high crit damage, he's literally going to eat the shit out of everybody. I recommend more so a violent blade build on him. You could definitely do like a rage blade starting out, but definitely shift into violent blade because you want Calicus to have as many turns as possible. Mainly because you want him to be able to do chow down whenever he can. And as long as he can do chow down as often as possible, he will deal as much damage to the enemy as possible. Incapacitate, of course, since it lowers speed, will give you more opportunities to deal damage with this particular unit. Now, so what happens if you run into this particular unit in the arena? What do you do? He's one of those units similar to the Hellhounds that hit really, really hard that you don't want to take for granted. So if you see him, especially since he has an AoE, he's going to be dealing heavy damage. You don't want to run into the situation where you have any of your allies with lower than 60% HP, just because he's going to deal more damage, basically up to 100% more damage based on your current HP circumstance. So you don't want to risk having this unit have free reign and, you know, basically be biting off a piece of that ass every time because you chose to be like, ah, whatever, I don't care about Calicus, whatever the fuck, right? So make sure you end this unit quickly and then deal with units that are supporting him later. So like if you see him with Chasun, kill him first and then take care of Chasun later. That will help you quite a bit in dealing with this particular unit. So this again is Calicus is a relatively simple unit to build, has very high damage dealing capabilities, but again, he's one of those units that are going to take a lot of work in order to be effective. So I would recommend really kind of building him, you know, late to end game after your core teams are done, and then after that you'll have a strong standpoint to really grow from with this particular unit. So that covers it for Calicus, guys. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and we will see you guys next video. So thank you guys for so much again, every single one of you. I love every single one of you guys. Thank you for your support and you know, your interaction in the community, and we will see you guys next video.